Smart man, you know what else he should do? If this continues, take them all to dinner.
Gonzalez to add the PAT. And it's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead. So two plays on that scoring drive. That's how they drew it up. And the long run into the end zone, and what a run it was. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Jacksonville set to roll again on the offensive side of things. You know, you and I talked about these Jaguars on this broadcast before the season started, and we thought there's a wide range of possible outcomes for them from 12-4 to 4-12. Well, unfortunately, at 6-10, they were closer to the latter.
And I do believe we were leaning towards that. I didn't expect them to be division champs. I definitely didn't expect 6-10, though. And this is a team that should be better than that. It looks like they're trying to solve whatever level of confusion there is in their front office. They made some changes there. But the head coach, Doug Marone, will return and have an opportunity to get things corrected and get them back to playing football like they did a couple seasons ago when they went to the AFC Championship game.
One thing, though, Charles, they didn't lack for intrigue with Foles going out, Minshew coming in.
And Foles went out week one.
Yeah, that was early.
First quarter.
And then you had Jalen Ramsey getting shipped out of town out west. So there were a lot of storylines.
There certainly were. But I say the number one storyline when you're looking for the positive, Gardner Minshew, sixth-round pick out of Washington State. Minshew mania takes over not just Jacksonville, but in a lot of ways the entire NFL. And now my understanding is that his offseason, he's going to spend part of it on an RV trip across America. Go get him, Gardner.
14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. They'll run with a big man, Bo Jackson. And he's going to take this across mid.
Entering pause screen, resume.
Field into Jacksonville territory. The last run got nine. That leaves him with second and a yard. On second down, this is Jackson. He'll get 15 and a Vikings first down.
And he continues to pile up the yardage. That puts him over a buck 50 now. And this defense has really had its problems trying to keep him contained.
They run on first down with Jackson. There he goes again. And finally taken down at the 15.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. And he's brought down. 15 yards last play and 15 yards here this go-around. A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
Back to throw. Cunningham. Now Cunningham has the ball knocked down. So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. From a yard out. And the Vikings are going to widen that advantage.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Gonzalez now to add the extra point. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. This one caught by Winslow. And he gets in. Well, no one was expecting a fake there, but they add two more onto their lead. He hits the big target for the two-point try. Defenses hate those guys, especially around the goal line.
It's hard to decide who you're going to put on him. Are you going to put a smaller corner on him? Are you going to put a safety who doesn't have maybe the same coverage skills? How about a linebacker? He may have the size, but he's not used to really covering in space. That's why the tight end gives you such a great advantage when you're throwing the football.
And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. Murray now to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Danielle Hunter with a big-time sack on third down. It's a loss of seven.
Three scores down, not even a halftime yet. They are not getting much generated offensively. They've got to figure it out.
It's tough because this defense just seems to be playing with so much confidence right now.
They really are. They are on their toes, and they're getting at them.
Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at their own 42. Here's Cunningham. He's going to take a shot right away for the end zone. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. A big play there. As time expires in the first half. And the Vikings are going to widen that advantage. And now this will be the final play of the half, as with no time remaining, now Cunningham has the ball knocked down. First half in the book. You want the third quarter already? No problem. Let's do it. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And they will not get a chance to return this one, as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Out come the Jaguars now as he'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. And now the Vikings are going to stop it here on defense with a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. On the ground, Jacobs will get the third quarter started. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. On second and nine, Murray. And this one complete to Reed. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
And they'll get him down after a pickup of eight, second and two. Just what you want on a first down run, call it 8 yards, and it's second and two. From midfield now on second down, Murray. The Sanders has got it, complete.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him.
Jordan Reed, touchdown, Jaguars. Jordan Reed, 44 yards. And the Jaguars make some inroads here on that deficit. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. It's the Vikings' turn on offense. We get ready for their first possession of the second half. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. You're 3 scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in two-minute offense. This is what NFL offenses call four-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. It's a gain of 11 as the Vikings pick up the first. Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. Now Jackson. And he's going to take this across midfield into Jacksonville territory. Jordan Phillips is the one on the stop. On second down, it's Jackson. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards. And it'll bring up a third and two more. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we've played 3 quarters. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. On third down, this is Jackson. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It's a gain of 16, and the Vikings have the first down as well.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know, well conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's a gain of 11 as the Vikings pick up the first. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. And he's brought down. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. Starting to look like this drive, it may be the final nail in the coffin.
Well, this is why you work out so hard, right? This is why you spend all that time in the offseason. This is why you have those OTAs and mini camps for these situations, these scenarios, to run someone into the ground and secure a victory.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. And he will not get away. He's sacked back around the 3-yard line.
And on second and goal, they decide to throw it again. And this result is even worse. They take a sack. On first down, it was simply an incomplete pass. Not a good first two plays, beginning with...
He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. Calvin Johnson there to make the grab. And the Vikings are going to widen that advantage.
Is it okay if I break one of our rules, partner, which is to never call a game over until it's over? Because this certainly feels like it's over after that drive.
Yeah, that was spirit-crushing, wasn't it? And now you just kind of felt the air go out of the balloon.
Yeah, they were fighting so hard to stay in there, and they knew they had to stop them on that drive. But when they were unable to, I think you're exactly right. You could see them sag on their sideline. And I think this one might just be over.
Let's go! Let's do it!
Out comes the Jacksonville offense as they get set to take over here. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And a coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
Throwing is Murray on third down. He's going to let it fly. He's got a man complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. On third and 10, they go flying past the marker and get nearly 40 yards. On first and 10, here's Murray. Defensively, I know they have the comfortable lead here in the fourth, but they do not want to give up big plays like that.
They want to finish strong. So oftentimes in this situation, you tighten up underneath in your coverage and you bring your safeties back. They can pick up anything that leaks through. But in the meantime, upfield, you're making plays on the football.
Now they got to get to the line quickly. Now Murray again. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 14 seconds to go in the game. And they're going to at least line up to go for it here on fourth down. Murray and company going for it on fourth. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Vikings defense is going to get the football back. Good starting field position for the Vikings as they have it first and 10 at their own 44. Cunningham. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And we will get a timeout with two ticks left. Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal. Cunningham looking to throw. Yeah, he's got it. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. I tell you, Charles, you play to the final whistle, I get that, but there are a few folks that might not be too happy with that score late in the game with it already well in hand.
You seem a little squeamish about that last score.
I struggle with it. I struggle. But he's going to be swallowed up and taken down. Sacked back at the 5-yard line. Well, we saw action to the final whistle in this one. Not only the touchdown at the end to add to their lead, then they tried to put more on top of the 2-point conversion but didn't get it.
Screenplay for players, cats. Entering statistics, screen players, cats, team 6. Post game report, players, cats. Entering new item screen, 1,000 coins.
Are you ready for some football? Ladies and gentlemen.
Missions. Entering ways to complete. Entering mission steps. Entering mission select. Win 7. Win 10 games. Complete a week. Win 7 games in solo battle deselected. Entering mission steps. Entering mission. Entering and colors. Entering mission select. Words. Earn. Welcome. Earn colors. Smash master battery sender. Entering. Entering ways to complete screen. You have 2 options. Color smash master satisfaction missions. Entering ways. Entering missions. Entering words. Earn earn colors. Entering. Entering way. Entering. Entering mission select words. Entering mission steps screen. UNNY. CO. Entering ways to complete screen. COLOR set is selected. Missions. Entering way. Entering mission. Letter. Entering ways to complete screen. Word scram. Entering challenge select. Go sequence setup. You have 3 options. Normal is selected.
Y'all can't get close, so why you wanna touch us? Cause my team is so hard. My team is legit. Madden 20. Snoop Dogg is. I get it. I got cleats on my feet. Jersey on my back. Helmet on my head. Ready to attack like that.
Down in Mississippi and New Orleans, Big Snoop Dogg got a Madden lead. His team is off the hook and you don't really want none, but if you do, come and get some. See, tell your mama and tell your daddy.
Hey folks, it's the coach here. Welcome back for another exciting matchup in Madden Ultimate Team. Taking you the rest of the way, here's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis. Brandon.
So no scoring in our first half. What will the second half bring as we are now back underway? This is taken near the 13. And he'll weave his way up, all the way up, a few yards shy of midfield.
Well, that return gives him a golden opportunity to go out in front. How will the defense respond after giving up that type of a return?
Out come the Vikings. They'll have it first on offense as we begin the third. There are 0 points on the scoreboard for either side. It'll be interesting to see what adjustments were made. The defenses have obviously been great.
So if you like defense, this is a classic game. This is what you're looking for. But now you're trying to figure out how to gain any type of an advantage on offense. Is it through a big chunk play that they haven't seen before? Or is it just running your regular offense and running it better, trying to create an opportunity?
We'll see which avenue they choose to go down. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 10 yards, and it's good for a Viking first down.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
The 20. Oh, and now touchdown, Vikings. A great play there. 40.